What do we call the app?
Take a break, we'll be back right now. I'm going to go with Fred's advice.
Yeah.
I'll let things stand.
Well,
Artie,
I think that's very nice of you.
Right. And, then,
and Artie, you stop giving people advice.
That was not good advice.
Listen,
Bob, don't call Artie for advice.
I'll cop to it. I feel like I would rather get punished than Bob.
Right. All right.
Gary, Bob never officially apologized to you.
Oh, excuse me.
I don't think he really feels sorry for what he said. He's like, hey, I was pissed. It's tough shit.
It's art in there. Oh, excuse me. Inventory.
Bob Levy had a meltdown on the Angry Man show. Miserable Man show.
Yeah, I talked to Bob yesterday for like 2 hours on the phone.
Yeah, Bob claims that you're full.
It's my inventory.
Well, I don't know exactly what he said because I didn't hear it, what we talked about on the phone, I thought he had legitimate rights.
All right. Here's the background on this. Bob requested to come on the show to promote one of his gigs. Gary told him it wasn't time yet. You know, we space out certain people.
Right.
All people, not certain people. Bob's not being targeted in any way. We love Bob. But Gary felt okay. This, you know, I mean, gently said, not this month. We're booked up this month. Which, you know, Gary spaces this stuff out. That's what I asked him to do. That's his job. And so Bob reacted in this manner. First of all, I should give you some background to this. After Gary gently told this to Bob, his new wife or girlfriend, I don't know if she's a wife yet.
No.
I was wrong on that. I thought that was her and it wasn't. I didn't realize the show would air unless I was it. So it wasn't his fiance that emailed me.
Oh, who was that?
I didn't realize the show would air unless I guess somebody heard Bob talking and sent me that note.
Oh, okay. That wasn't his fiance. All right, good. All right, so here's Bob melting down. Bob has a wrestling background, right?
Here's the entrance.
Yes.
He sounds like a wrestler.
Yes.
He sounds like a wrestler. Listen to this.
After all the shit that I do,
his entrance.
Right, yeah. Just plug this fucking thing. I got an email back that, oh no, we're a little too busy this month. Oh yeah? Oh, let me see. Who the fuck is on then? Okay? Who are these superstars?
Email from who?
Gary, okay. You can't give me fucking 15 minutes after all these years being your fucking guy. Your fucking guy, as you say. I'm your fucking guy. I talked to Artie today. Artie's 100% on my side saying that it's a disgrace for them to fucking even say no to me. It's a fucking disgrace. They gave me 15 minutes.
You know, why don't we just open up the door to Bob Levy? And
come in anytime.
Anytime. Because Bob should be on at any given second.
Well, I don't think he's asking for any time.
No, first of all, let me tell you something. We have Bob on. Let Bob finish. We're all fairness. I like Bob, so I'm not going to get worked up.
I have some big paintings, but they're missing.
Okay, I don't need to be fucking loyal to one fucking show for fucking all these years and get smacked in the fucking face. Nobody else that comes on to that fucking show sits there, writes bits for nothing, does shit for nothing, comes up here to film a 10-second intro to a fucking roast show when I'm 3 hours away for nothing. I've been doing this for fucking years, and you ain't gonna fucking smack me in the fucking face by telling me you don't got 15 minutes for me. Fuck you. Fuck you!
Well, first of all, after that first tirade, I'll play another one. I have to back Gary up. Number one, Bob, this show isn't about who the guest is. We have to sit and space those things out. Secondly, how dare you? I mean, my God, we gave you your own show. You're on the air, right? You're on the air. We don't give that to hardly anyone, lest you forget that. Not only that, every person who comes in here, Sal and Richard and all of them, talk about Bob Levy's new comedy club, and they're appearing there. We've never given a person so much access, and quite frankly, Gary,
that's what I think. He's gonna have
your fucking future as a comedian.
So you're making a statement, right? What is your statement that you're saying?
You think I got a lot of fucking balls for turning me down for a fucking 15-minute spot to help out guys on that fucking show? that fucking that I've been fucking paying for on the road out of my fucking pocket. You know what I mean? You can't have me come in for 15 fucking minutes. I'd say a whole fucking interview. I could have been on every fucking radio station around the country. I saved it for fucking hours. Okay? And you can't have me on?
I said to him, Bob, I don't think, and this is a lack of communication, I said, I don't think Howard is going to mind if you do morning radio in another city.
I don't mind at all.
I said, Bob Schimmel goes out to meet Nick DiPaolo. They got to make money and they got to plug. So I said, Bob,
any show he wants.
I said, start taking those jobs, first of all, where you can get on and plug. I said, I've never heard Howard begrudge a comic that ever.
Absolutely not. That would be obnoxious.
He's also being very transparent when he says that I'm helping these guys, because while he's helping those guys, he's also helping himself.
Right. Of course,
you know, and he's being transparent. Listen, if I find out Bob's doing a gig and all the money's going to Sal and Richard and none of it's going to him, then he's really helping
those
guys.
What is this exclusive he's saying for? Said he's moving out of his basement?
I think it was the Danny Bonaducci thing. What was that?
Well, I think he was married.
That's an exclusive?
Please, nobody wants that story.
What is so great about that story, that he's getting married?
Like, the last couple times he came in, the stuff with the wife was funny, you know?
It's funny.
Who wants that story? It's not like he's Tom Cruise.
Yeah, I mean...
I feel bad that he doesn't have it.
People magazine are bidding for this story.
Already.
Wait, let me finish the meltdown. And you put on a fucking somebody that has a fucking napkin in their fucking ass? Fuck you!
What?
And I ain't fucking kidding anymore. Well, doesn't he eat blue cheese out of a woman?
He was saying that we put on ass napkin ad. That's an example of a guy that we would put on, but not him.
Well, ass napkin ad is good.
Ass napkin ad was on the last time.
He hasn't
been
on it. I think it was on this year.
It's on once. He was on one time, man.
If I'm not good, fuck you, Gary. Fuck you. Listen to the same kid. Fuck Gary. Okay. Gary's. Listen, I know Gary. I goof on Gary on the air all the time. And I'm like, but Gary's my guy. And you don't say fuck Gary, and that gets me fucking crazy. What do you mean fuck Gary?
Well, because you got to say fuck Howard.
Well, that's
what
point.
Fuck Gary is fuck
right.
Howard.
I think so.
Absolutely. You're the same as me. So that better to you. Look.
I really think you ought to talk to
Bob. When you say fuck Gary, you're saying fuck Howard.
Come on, Bob. You gotta call in if you're
really.
I'm sure you
know. Bob will call me 7 hours later. I go on stage. I get the fucking pop. You ask Artie who gets a fucking pop. I get a pop as big as anybody. Bigger than fucking anybody else. Me and Artie. Ask him.
What the fuck?
Sick of shit. I don't know.
Cheers and lacrosse.
Somebody said that's a wrestling term.
Yeah. Now, I think this was a little bit wrestling. But, no.
Shit.
This is very outrageous. No, you gotta take everything away. That's it. Done. No more.
Come on, reconsider.
No, Artie, you gave him bad advice.
I didn't give him any advice.
It's Artie's fault.
I should tell him to say, fuck Gary.
You should have smacked him into reality.
No, I didn't like the fact that, you know, a friend of mine...
He was a little out of line. He's saying, fuck Howard on my channel.
Artie, are you a friend of yours already?
Yeah, God, I don't do that. I wasn't sitting there going, fuck Gary.
He didn't say fuck Gary.
Yeah, I was like, you're right, fuck Gary.
When you fuck Gary, you're fucking me. That's all I'm saying.
I was just saying, I really felt bad that, you know, a lot of people were in this financial
street. He's now very offended by the way he was spoken about.
And you know what? He's the only comedian. We did this for him because he does the roast for us and puts us together.
Right.
Like, I think,
I thought the roast and making him the roast master was a big thrill for him. Maybe you should take him off that.
I think the point for Bob is if we put Bob on the show often, he gets to plug what he wants to plug. Nobody gets paid to be here. You know what I mean? Like, any guest that comes on, they get to come on, and what they get paid in is plugs. And we let Bob plug gigs when he's not here. Like, Fred O'Reilly's plug once a week.
I know.
That's an enormous gift.
He clearly doesn't appreciate it. He thinks we don't do anything for him. Well, Fred, stop reading that.
He's not.
I mean, let's cut it out. I mean, it's just clearly upsetting the guy.
Now Bob's getting less plugs.
Yeah, of course. I mean, I never heard a guy go so nuts about nothing.
It's
great
that he has his own show and stuff, but obviously, I mean, a plug on this show during the bulk of the show, that's good.
But whenever Bob calls in, I pick up the phone call, and he always plugs.
And all the guys on the... Sal will be on the wrap-up show, and he'll go, hey, by the way, could I mention it would be a Bob Levy's club this weekend? I mean, he's got more access than anybody's ever had.
No, he's being a bit piggish here about his access. I believe, and I'm going to back Gary up on this. I don't think Bob's being fair.
What happened? You told him on the phone he was right?
No, well, I didn't know the extent of everything he said on the air last night, but I know a lot of comedians aren't lucky enough to have a steady income, and people are hurting now for money. And,
right. But, and Bob is so loyal to the show. He was on Kid Chris's almost every day.
And I hear through the grapevine that part of what's freaking him out, this is what the guys in the office are telling me, is that now that Kid Chris isn't on, it's freaking him out. It's got less places
to be.
I think he figured that Kid Chris was a friend of the show. I don't know.
We never said to Bob, don't go on there, but he's so loyal. I mean, stay on our show. But no, I don't have a problem with him doing that. I don't sit in tantrum and go, you did another show.
Right.
I mean, I don't, I don't sit in tantrum. I think we've been very loyal to Bob.
Do you think you ought to talk to Bob about this?
No, I'm never talking to Bob about
this.
That's Gary's job. I'm not gonna undermine Gary.
Not even on the air?
That's what I'm saying.
On the air.
Maybe we should be discussing this.
See, it's funny, though, because Bob, it's hard to have a reasonable conversation with him about this sort of thing, and it's one of the reasons I sent him an email.
Also, Bob,
I should have picked up the phone, but I knew Bob was going to yell at me and argue with me.
Bob also has bad timing. Like, right now would be great to talk to Bob.
He's not a
criminal. He'll call in about 2 hours from now, but I don't want to talk about this.
I would assume he'd be up now, especially after that late.
Listen to this.
Let's just say, I'm playing devil's advocate, they don't have time. And they couldn't squeeze you in.
We should have time all the time for Bob, shouldn't we?
Overreacting a little bit.
No, 15 fucking minutes, Julie. You know what the fuck I do.
I know. I'm just...
And I'm fucking behind all those motherfuckers. Every fucking person back there. Mm. I'm fucking there for. You know what I mean? Out of my own fucking money, making sure that these motherfuckers get paid.
By the way, is he referring to Sal and Richard?
Yeah. I think so.
Yeah.
I think so. I think he's saying that he hires Sal and Richard and Julie.
He hires Sal and Richard because they're on the show.
Right. Like, if they weren't on the show, would he be so generous?
I mean, don't you think Sal and Richard at this point could go out and do a little show together?
I thought he was talking about Beetlejuice and the Iron Sheik.
Oh,
but again,
I didn't ask him to do that.
Well, at this point, I guess Sal and Richard would need a guy to do 45 minutes, and they can't do that yet. But they need each other in a lot of ways.
Right.
But, I think a lot of people are just broke, and some people are losing it. It's a crazy time.
Hardy, I understand, but the guy's making a lot of accusations about Gary. I mean, listen to this.
Hardy, if we fuckers leave with fucking money, all I ask is to promote a fucking show, and it's a slap in the face. And Hardy,
and whenever we can't have Bob on, we always say, Fred, give Bob a plug. I mean, I don't know. I've always been very gracious to Bob.
Does he call in, like, every week or once? Every few months, I don't
know. No, but the fact of the matter is, what comedian can you name that we allow Fred to do plugs for when he just has a gig coming up? We do it because we like Bob.
That's the
only reason. I'm not looking for Bob to do any work for free.
You know that we passed on Gilbert the last time he asked to come on. He's coming on in a couple of weeks, but it's got to be Eve Gilbert, who we love, who's got carte blanche as a show. It just had to be spaced out.
We can't have a relationship with a comedian if we're not allowed to say no to him. And then the show that I give him at night, he's busy bad-mouthing Gary because Gary said no? I mean, come on.
Artie, put a hole right up here. He's 100% behind me. It's a fucking...
Artie's behind you because Artie's sitting in the car.
Artie's not going to argue.
I wasn't in the car.
Whatever.
No, I do care about Bob.
Care about Bob. I'm talking about you're not going to get into an argument with him about this.
A lot of people say they care about Bob, but the fact is this show puts its money where its mouth is. We do allow Bob access that we don't allow a lot of other comedians. Let me tell you something. Don't think Dice Clay wouldn't like me to give him a plug every week where he's appearing. Don't think there isn't. I can name you a million comedians who go, how come Bob gets all of these favors? We do it because we just kind of like the guy. I'm not asking him to do anything.
How come Jim Florentine doesn't call me and say, hey, listen, could you plug my gig every week?
He's fucking Nicole.
Well, before that.
You guys taking liberties.
Hello there, guys. Welcome.
Bob gets a daily plug on this show, and I'm not even sure why. Why does he get a date?
Because you know what? He was doing a lot of stuff with the roast. And I don't know. You know what? The squeaky wheel. He pounds away and pounds away and pounds away. And we're like, okay, well, he asks for it.
All right. You know what you got to do with him? He's being a bit spoiled. We're giving him a lot. Take everything away. Take it all away.
Does that include the Angry Man show?
Everything. Take it all away. And then maybe if I feel gracious, I'll let him have something in a year.
I
don't like the attitude.
Tell him he can talk
to us. Spoiled child.
He can talk to us after the All-Star break.
No, but
he's not being fair.
Yeah, here's the thing. It's also a lack of communication.
He's not being nice.
I think
You could have helped him already by saying, shut up, Bob.
Right. You could, if you
when did I say shut up,
Bob? When you were talking to the phone, you said, Bob, you know what?
I don't like the placement of that.
Say shut up. I don't give him any advice on that. But
it works.
Hold on. What is it, Tim?
Last night, before I talked to him about, he said, I'm going to, you know, do this rant. I said, you better think about it before you go on there and do something like this, because the fans misinterpret all of this stuff. I mean, this is a platform for a lot of these comedians, a lot of these people to get exposure. It's a part of...
Bob, he gave you some exposure. I
exactly
know,
right.
It's a comedian's dream. I can't tell you how many comedians... Greg Fitzsimmons said to me, you give me an hour to do my thing? I go, yeah, absolutely. I mean, come on. This is being a bit piggish.
And that's a perfect example. Like, Greg Fitzsimmons doesn't call me and say, hey, listen, I've got a gig this week. Plug it.
Yeah.
You know, we help out where we can.
No, this is being outrageous.
Insult. That they can't fucking give me 15 fucking minutes for all the shit that I've done.
Not only that, but I'm with Bob for another
one. This is Al Rosenberg. Take the show away from me.
Wait a minute. Al was going along with
it. Yeah. Al goes along with whatever. Al doesn't even stick up for me.
Every time Bobby's on that show, it's a fucking home run. You hit a home run every time you're on the show.
I have a different story every fucking time. I'm a fucked up individual. I get asked to be on fucking every fucking radio show, and I turn them down. And I turned them down, and I talked to Artie today, and Artie said, take him.
Yeah, take him.
Well,
that's
out. I don't
know
what...
No.
Some people, are not grateful. Some people are a little less charming than others. And Bob is one of those guys, for some reason, we've chosen to really bestow a lot of plugs and make him part of the show and make him part of
the channels.
I mean, we don't do this for any comedian. There's very few. Right. So Bob's been one of those guys that we just like. And Bob's a fun guy, and I like Bob. But, you know, this is you playing the middle too, Artie. Which side do you want? I mean, look, I mean, I'm not talking about anybody's financial situation. I'm talking about, hey, wait a second. We've done a few things for this guy.
You could have said the show's been good to you.
Of course I said that.
He's out of line.
We had a two-hour conversation.
I'm not going to yell about it, but the fact of the matter is, and fuck Gary, and everyone's a big shot, but okay, fuck Gary. Like, you want to fuck Gary. And go on all the other shows. As far as I know, Bob goes on every show.
And he's never been told he can't.
No, he doesn't. And I always told him, Bob is extra loyal in the sense that he won't even do those local morning radio shows because he's afraid of what happens.
Well, of course. And because we give him tons of plugs. Joe, you're on the air.
Hey, you know what? The fact is, Bob has this comedy club in Pleasant now. He wouldn't even have that fucking thing if it wasn't for you. You'd think he'd be a little more fucking grateful.
Yeah. This is a little bit offensive, let's be honest. Chico, you're on the air.
Fuck, baby. He goes on this fucking bullshit show up in Albany, New York all the time. I went to see him in Schenectady about a year ago. He did a piss poor show. Eating fucking blue cheese, fucking. He's a bum. Fuck him. Take everything.
Well, no, he does go on other shows.
Well, he tells me he doesn't go on any show.
He went on Kid Chris every day, and I love Chris, and I'm fine with that. But the fact of the matter is, he goes on lots of shows, so go on any show.
He goes on waking up with the ball from the guy in the fucking hat. He steals public shit, steals jersey shit.
In Albany?
He's a Career Channel guy, and he plays an accident all the time.
Who?
All right, well, there you go. So, all right, thanks, Chico. Thank you. I mean, that's a little out of line. Come on.
He obviously never screamed at me, fuck Gary, at all. I mean, I would never.
I mean, but Gary goes out of his way to be nice to Bob. And Gary will call me all the time, okay, Bob wants a plug here, Bob wants a plug at the end of the show. I said, give it to him.
Well, what did you say to him?
Nothing. I said, listen, I mean, you know, you're going to have to. Relating to the show, I could, you know, try to give him some advice. I said, right now there's a lack of communication. You have to, I'm guaranteed, if you ask Gary, is it okay to do those other shows, he'll say fine, especially with the climate right now.
So, you've always said fine.
I never thought about doing this, but I'll tell you something. This is where
that's what he's thinking in his own head.
Okay, so talk to me about it, but this is where I think Bob is retarded. This is the biggest, dumbest thing that he could do. So he goes on that show last night, right? I've been trying to call him to come on right now just because I think it's good for our show right now.
Right.
He does that last night. He's going to drop an atomic bomb and then just fucking sleep.
Right.
Like, you would think he would be up first thing in the morning ready to deal with this if it came up. And he's asleep.
He usually
is. So if he wants to get on the show, now would be the time.
Right. And he would know he's going to drop that.
I thought I had a bigger lamp.
Exactly. Well, what am I going to say? That's an unfair. I happen to think that's an unfair.
Sweetie. ass.
I do. I don't think it's justified.
Is Bob for real, or is this just like his way of getting back on the show without asking
him
back on
the show? For real, but he's playing a little bit.
It's a little bit of that wrestling shit.
But you know what? He gets like this.
It doesn't look good there.
Sometimes he thinks that's a contribution to us.
Yeah. Benji's now focusing on his music career. I wish he'd leave. I mean, what? Hey, when he comes, tell him to go home.
Does anybody know where he is? There's no been no call.
We're going to make a call right now.
I mean, unless he's dead or sick, I'm sure.
Yeah, dead is a good excuse.
Well, dead, I'll say anything. If someone's dead, I understand why they're not here, and I would be sad.
That is a perfect excuse.
Yeah. I mean, the guy works 3 days a week for 4 hours. I don't know that he puts in any time after the 4 hours.
No, he goes home and plays with his girlfriend now.
Yeah, and that's another thing.
She's not doing anything but waiting for him to get home.
And that's another thing around here. Like, I'm going to start, like, talking to people about what they actually do for me. Because a lot of them just are kind of fucking dead weight. Yeah, don't fire Benji, Gary. I'm going to go look for some replacement. You know, Robin's right. He's around.
This is a mess.
You say to someone, you're gone. They go, oh, don't worry. That's in your budget. And then the money's gone. Like, if I wanted to hire Artie back or hire an Artie replacement, I couldn't do it now.
Right. You don't have any money for it.
No. And it's not that we spent any more money. They just take it away, even though that wasn't the deal. Even though that wasn't the deal. The complete opposite was explained to me. And it's unbelievable around here. I've so had it. I mean, it's just impossible to do business. Yeah, that's easy. This is the, what you're hearing on the air is the easy part.
You're sitting, come on.
Yeah, they got that down. I don't really have to worry.
show up.
No, no, no. Oh. Around there, if you don't show up, you're fired. Oh. Like, everyone shows up. And the people over there work so fucking hard. Oh, my God. There ain't no standing around up there.
They get their money worth out of their people.
Their people are getting money worth. JD, for one.
Yeah.
That fucker works hard. I don't care how much mouth he is. That guy works hard.
Everybody can speak.
They're good. Many more people can't speak. Jason and Will work hard.
Yeah.
I know what they're up to. I know. I'm wise. I don't know. I don't know how hard they work. Although they
I noticed that Sal comes up with good ideas.
He does. I'm busting balls. There's a lot of people around here who work hard. But there are a few deadbeats. And I know who they are. They think they're slick. Deadbeats. And here's Benji. Hey, Benji, I told Gary not to let you in.
Probably snuck by.
I told Gary not to let you in. Why? I told you not to let him come in.
I thought you wanted to talk to him.
I don't. How could you be late? We work 3 days a week and you just had 2 weeks off. What the fuck is wrong with you?
Enough, please.
I'm gonna find your replacement first, because whenever I get rid of somebody or they leave, they take the budget away from me. But you don't mind just hanging in there for a few minutes.
You're a space filler.
Do you think Julie could do a Benji job much better?
I don't know.
Isn't he a comedian?
Talk to Julie.
I mean, Julie does like stand up and stuff. Gary, have Shuli sit next to Benji for a couple of weeks and let's see what kind of stuff he puts out. And then I can fire Benji. Okay?
Thanks.
Benji, do you mind?
Why are you asking if he minds?
Ooh,
love him. He just walked in here, how about 20 minutes late?
I just want to know if he minds if Benji has a shattering.
Shattering?
Yeah. Hey, I tried to be a decent human being. Tell me why you're late. You are insane. Why are you late?
I got up early.
I was up at 2, so go ahead. I was probably up when you were. Okay. What time did you get up early?
For me, I got up around 4. I'm very tired.
What are you taking up? Why don't you stop working on that fucking shitty music with your girlfriend? And concentrate on your fucking job that pays you.
I do.
No, you don't. You're busy with that. Does Wolfie write jokes, Karen? Is he sort of a comedy writer? Because he's a fucking workaholic.
Yeah, he's always coming up with stuff.
I don't know if Wolfie writes jokes.
Just call him and maybe I'll try Shirley for a week and Wolfie and then I'll get rid of Benny. Time. Yeah, anyway, so what were you saying, Benji? You took a sleeping pill. What time did you take a sleeping pill? What do you take, Ambien?
No. Oh.
What is it? What's the stuff you take?
What is it?
What is that? Extended PM? That shit don't work. I mean, he's claiming that. Knock him out. So what time do you take a sleeping pill? A couple hours before what? What time did you take a sleeping pill? Oh, okay. And then what happened? Your alarm didn't go off?
It did, and I lost it.
Why are you so tired? You're doing it. You really fucking don't. You're coming for 4 hours a day.
The fuck?
Job, seriously, what do you do besides? I mean, you write jokes during the show, but I don't know if Richard and Sal work with them or anything else. I mean, you got a good fucking deal. I check Lotus notes and stuff. He hasn't contributed an idea since June.
What's the
like I get a note from Sal. the material, the extra material for his girlfriend when they're in the studio writing those dumb songs.
I did.
Do me a favor, please don't introduce any new songs while you can't show up on time. And you can't fucking contribute. Good lord. I don't know what you're doing. How's your marathon training?
Yeah. Oh, that's why you did
that. Yeah. If you're training for a marathon and you can't sleep, the hell am I?
Then you're in trouble.
No. He's got tons of free time. I mean, 4 hours a day, 3 days a week. He works 12 hours a week. That's it. What the rest of you do this show? He has nothing else to do. And he was like a half hour late. That's amazing. He's the only guy who's ever late. Fred's never late. I mean, like, once in a while, somebody has to be late. Like, Gary, like, in the winter, it's hard. It's pretty good.
It's a real issue.
Yeah, but the guy's been with me 30 years.
I live around the corner.
Yeah. I don't know what it is.
Go.
If he's interested in the position, and then the following week, find out.
She's still cleaning? She better be.
Yeah.
This place, oh, she's just eating shit.
Hi, Peg.
Hey. Good morning, Howard.
Oh, please. Please load the fucking dishwasher. This place is a dump. Thank you. Then
he's on the road, he's organizing a block party.
And Benji's fuck.
And I know Shirley can use the extra dough. 3 days a week and just at the city or write a couple of lines.
Is Elsa?
You know, when you listen to like Eric the
Ben knew that
you can go into a spine because it's ridiculous. But
Benji
is
afterwards.
Ask if Shirley takes sleeping pills. If that's the one.
Why would he need that? I mean, you would think see that a boring ass life would put him to sleep.
Okay.
I mean, if you're really that interesting to keep him up all night long.
I don't know, but he's busy with like this music career and it's just going nowhere.
Yeah,
hey, Peggy. Hey, Peggy. Hey, Peggy, you're sleeping beside you.
Oh, I got two dogs.
And that's who you'll have sleeping beside you forever.
I guarantee you're not going to be sleeping beside you once
you're not. When you lose this gig,
I want to see how long she stays with you, dude.
Okay,
trust me. I guarantee you it ain't going to be that long.
All right.
You want to bet?
Yeah, I want to bet.
Yeah, I bet you within a year she's gone.
Okay, bet me $1 million.
After you leave? Well, yeah, for $1 million.
Right, then she'll pay me $1 million.
Again, that's another big part.
Then bet me $1.
Okay. Second, please. I don't know, 30-something years, Robin and I. I can't even remember.
Missed call?
I turn on that microphone every morning with a
she's in the studio or not? Because she's there. I don't have to work.
She's an angel.
An angel. That's right. That's right.
It's also that this is a great job.
Music.
You know, this is the problem. He's never had a bad job.
No, he was an intern and then he worked for me. But don't worry, you'll soon find out, Benji, what it's like to work out there. I'm sure they're going to grab you at Saturday Night Live or Letterman or Leno. But in the meantime, you know, get ready for the wake up. And I'm actually doing you a favor. You know, I told you I'm working with somebody from GTD, getting things done. She said, don't you realize you're doing people a favor when you fire them? I go, how do you mean? And she said to me, if they're not functioning on their job, and you hold on to them, then when you actually do leave or something happens, they're not prepared for any other job.
Right.
That you're actually coddling them. If somebody's bad at their job, now they're going to go to a job where they really get their balls busted, and they're going to learn how to work. Your guys never learned how to work.
Second, blah, 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 blah.
But, I mean, does Benji not have fun?
He doesn't respect the job.
Of course, if you love your job.
He's funny with. What are you talking about?
I don't know what he is, but it's not my problem to figure it out.
You guys have a nice morning, and have a good night at ACT, Howard. I love
you. Thank you.
What's she doing?
Yeah, I mean, how is there two jobs you showing up on?
Oh, I'll be there early tonight. You know I work. I'm fucking Howard Stern, okay? But I could show up late tonight.
Sure. And nobody would say anything, because you deliver.
They gave me a call time tonight. They made it late, 5:40. You know what time I'll be there? I'll be there at 4 o'clock.
Yeah.
Because I do not want to be late. That's the kind. I'm a great employee. You hire me for a job, you can depend on me.
Did you notice that nobody comes here to see if you're here?
Fucking phone.
They expect us to show up because that's what they know us to do.
Dude, you got such a cush thing going on. You just haven't worked in radio yet, Benji. You only work for me. You don't know what it's like to put in a day at a radio station. $0 and you're there. You get off the air, then you do production, then you write fucking jokes, then you fucking write bits.
And then your boss yells.
Yeah, and then he tells you what a shit you are.
Well, I just go right.
You need to go. You need to get out there and work at another station. Then you'll come back and say, Howard, I blew it. I blew it. I had the best deal ever. I should have respected you. I haven't worked anywhere else ever. Where did you work? Here. That's it. What? B-103 where? Baltimore? Which B-103? What did you do there?
Bug out? On vacation. All right.
I don't think I have it here.
What did you play music?
Where's the bedroom?
What is
Let's go to bed.
College radio station?
Sleep.
It's something fishy of B-103. What is that? I never fucking heard of B-103.
I don't know if she's going. Afterwards. Oh, fuck.
It was a commercial station or was it a college station?
Commercial station.
All right. Well, then you have work somewhere. I stand corrected. I'm telling you, if I investigate this, it's going to be bullshit.
And I did sales.
I'm surprised you're not in the Radio Hall of Fame with that resume.
I'm trying.
You know, but there are guys in the Radio Hall of Fame with that resume. You know, I'm going to be inducted with them. By the way, Benji, I apologize. It's my fault you were dealing with work habits. Because I don't really fire anybody. I've been told I need to. No. I'm too much of a pushover. You're right. But don't worry. I'm going to help you. I know you're going to think I'm not helping you, but I am. Getting rid of you is the best thing that ever happened to you. Because you're going to go scrounge up some job. I don't know if it'll be in radio or I don't even know if it'll be in show business.
Or America.
Hey, I don't know. You might be working on the fucking Alaska pipeline for all I know. You're going to have to make a living, but it's going to teach you to appreciate what you got. I'm telling you I'm doing your thing. So don't be mad at me.
do. I like you personally. But again, your work habits are sloppy.
Professionally.
Professionally, I'm not crazy about you. Thank you. I hope personally and professionally.
Oh.
Thank you.
I'm amazed.
Thank you.
I'm not so amazed that you show up.
Yeah, maybe I'll just take a sleeping pill this afternoon. Miss AGT. Remember me, though. When people tune in, there'll be two judges.
And then when they ask you, you show up 20 minutes into the show.
Right.
You can have a sleeping pill.
You know, I'm such a fucking great judge. I can't take it.
what
I can't believe how good I am.
I can't believe that you haven't. David Hinckley surprises me because he should realize you're better than Simon Cowell.
Yeah, well,
Cal's probably looking at you going, you know what, I should be good. Well, how much good?
He is. He called me. He said, I can't believe how good you are. He kills me to say it.
Ah.
Simon Cowell.
I know he knows.
He's not a douche.
But, you know, these people are so used to their habits of, oh, Simon Cowell is the definitive judge. They can't break out of it.
The woman from Getting Things Done works with me.
Yeah.
I don't understand how you don't fire people. You're doing them a favor. She can't believe what a pushover.
Look at the time you guys are. The
fuck is that?
They were close. Like, they actually had a friendship.
Sorry,
no. You blow. Their ass is gone. No offense. Wow. Hey, King of All Blacks, is that you? Where you been hiding?
Hey, what's up, baby? I had a great start. Can you hear me?
No.
And you can hear me good, right? I got a new phone. You can hear me good.
Yeah.
It's not that good, but
come on.
It's not great.
Hey, listen. You know what girls do with guys like
cuckold. Cuckold, it's called. It's when a woman goes around flaunting herself in front of the men in front of her husband.
That.
My wife told me yesterday that a guy tried to talk to her in the back. And I thought
that new phone is for shit, pal. Goodbye. That's the new phone. What phone is he buying? That's horrible.
I love how we've gone from perfect phone connections to, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Today I got a new phone. Where did that phone from? Hi, Ryan. That's it. No more wrap-up show.
Thank you, sir.
He is punished. I have to treat him like a baby. No wrap-up show for you, Benji. The party's over. I know you'll love the wrap-up show.
That's where he's showing.
Yeah. Man, well, he gets to be Benji.
Yeah.
Don't be mad at me. Be mad at yourself.
I am.
All right. I'm sorry. But, listen, you leave me no recourse. And I look like a fool. I keep telling this guy he's going to lose his job and then I'm on fire.
Right.
But the wrap-up show, I think that's fair to take that away from me. Do you agree?
Me?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, whatever
I think that's fair.
Whatever you decide, it's your...
Well, I'm doing that for sure.
System is completely backward. Like, Dave doesn't interact with any of the writing staff or anybody.
Dave wouldn't even know about this problem.
No, like, Gary would handle it. Like, Rob Burnett would just handle it. You see, here's the thing.
No, but you have to, here's the thing.
Yeah, go ahead.
You have to give me the power.
Okay.
You have, in other words, you have to say, you know, if I can fire Benji.
Right.
I'm not going to say I'm going to, but I'm going to fire Benji, and that has to be it. But you,
so how would you handle this, honestly? Would you fire him?
No.
If you had the ultimate control.
Today, I mean, so I'm starting like I'm taking over, okay?
Right.
So I would probably tell him not to come in tomorrow. But
what the fuck?
You want to talk about that, when he doesn't come in,
right.
He's really getting hurt.
It's, the show is suffering.
The show suffers. So
but then that would give me an opportunity to try out Shuler.
See, that's something that we never discussed before.
Right.
So I would say, tell Benji, take a day or even a week. Maybe say next week, you know what? Maybe don't come in tomorrow, don't come in next week. You think about it.
Right.
You think about what you did.
Punishing a child.
But that's how it works.
Right.
You know, if this were...
You are a good parent.
If this were an office...
Right.
What the fuck are my chats on this crap?
5 years ago, 7 years ago,
right.
You start to... Every time this happens, you write it up, and it goes in the file. And then you have a
yeah.
file.
Right.
And then what you do is you get to a point where you take the file out and you say, listen, you got this, and this.
Do you feel Benji needs to be in the studio? Would you take him out of here?
Well, that's something that would kill him.
Yeah.
And that's something that would, you know, if you put him out of the studio... And let him earn his way back in, but then here's the problem. This is Benji's fault. Maybe out of the studio works better for you.
Right.
You know, and you wouldn't be in that position if he didn't put you there.
Right. Well, how about if I give you full control? And I don't have any, you know. I mean, you come to me about stuff. Like Rob Burnett goes to Letterman. I think that's how it works. Letterman, the only guy he meets with is Rob Burnett.
Right. The problem is again with the show is. You know, Letterman comes on stage, Letterman walks off.
Right.
When we have commercial breaks, that's when people get your ear.
Yeah.
And so you could say, if you were...
So now they're not allowed to talk to me anymore.
Well, you could say, you know what, I want Gary to handle it.
Yeah.
And I'll be fine with that.
All right. That's a new thing. I want to try.
Okay.
You're in charge.
I'm
just
with
work
that.
Here. You the boss.
Gary's going to handle it.
That's right.
And then I can double up back to you and I can discuss it.
Right.
Do you think you have the ability to fight?
Me?
Yeah.
It would be very tough. I've only ever fired one person, and you cry. And I swear to God, I swear, I'm not lying about this, I'm 90% sure, like, what's ready to slash my time.
Really?
The Delga?
I'm not lying.
Oh,
literally, the guy cried.
You boy, simple.
Go to work, please?
This is a long time ago. Okay, I work with like 6 months.
Same with this dumbass.
Right.
Made it work.
Clearly didn't know. So within 2 months, we decided we needed to build a file on him. So every time we did something wrong, we called him in. So I was surprised at how surprised he was by being fired.
Right.
Because we were building a file on him.
Right.
And he cried.
Yeah. Are you going to do that whole filing thing too, like on Benji? I like that. That's a good file.
I mean, we could, yeah.
Yeah.
That's what most companies do. It's an HR thing.
All right. You're in charge.
Okay.
Let's try it.
All right.
Because I give up. I can't manage this thing.
Tim and I will manage it.
Because I'll just quit. I've had it up to here that I don't even want to work here anymore. So if you run things, maybe I'll like working here better.
I've always been up for it.
So now I'm the good guy. Like all of a sudden, it's like, she's going to come to me. Gary just fired me, and I'm just going to go, Gary's fucked
Jeez.
Up.
What is going on?
Where's the kitchen? Damn it.
Yeah. He might even make you sit it out and tell you to sit into it. you think of that? Honestly.
Well, I wouldn't like that. I like my job.
Right.
So,
yeah. If you like it, show up. Smartest thing you can do in radio is show up. What happens when you don't show up on radio, Rob?
You get replaced.
And damn right.
My.
Exactly. Exactly how you get a fee.
All of a sudden, you hear somebody else getting a fee.
Yeah, it's weird. Like that.
Back.
So long. He is promoting the new movie that he is in with Sal Gabanelli and Ron Jeremy. Girls Gone Dead. I can even play you a clip. He just brought a clip with him. And the film is available on Amazon.com starting today. support, you know?
Bobby Elise. I'm all up and did it like 7 days.
7 days straight.
7 days straight.
Right. And you worked, you co-starred with Ron Jeremy, I understand.
Yeah.
She's a good guy? Good guy to work with?
Right.
Yeah. And, but he's not new to this. It's not a pornography thing, is it? It's a regular movie.
Right, right.
Yeah. And you're in it with Sal Gabanelli as well, right?
Right. I'm the director of all of it.
Oh, you did? You directed?
I direct all of it.
Oh, I didn't know that. I thought you just acted.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay. And Sal, you don't like this.
Well, Sal, he comes in
too late.
Famous! Oh!
You said to Gary, you were talking to him in the green room, he came in, he was pretty excited. You say that you think you're going to get the Academy Award for this movie.
Well, he not. I told him he wasn't.
No, I'm saying you're going to get the Academy Award.
Yeah, I'm the one going to get it. Not him.
Oh, come on. What are you
doing? Play. Can I play? What can I play?
Is your sister there too?
Well, I got a sister, yeah, but she died 2 years ago.
Your sister died? The one I met?
Yeah, she died 2 years ago.
Are you serious?
I'm serious, yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Wow, that's crazy.
This is crazy. I didn't know that. I'm so sorry. That lovely girl I met, your sister, died?
Yeah, she died before she died, yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
She talked to me before she died.
She did? What'd she say?
Well, she just told my mother to say hi before she died. That's all right.
Do you believe in life after death?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you do?
So she's up in heaven watching you.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's in a better place now, I guess.
She's in a better place, that's all.
Right. Are you Christian?
Me?
Yeah.
I'm not Christian.
Yeah.
You're Jewish?
Sure.
I am a Jewish guy.
You are? I didn't know you were Jewish. Why can't I fucking play this crap? You haven't been here that long. You stepped out to get something, you got lost for like 9 hours.
Oh, I stayed out for a half hour just to get out of
that. Half hour? I heard 9 hours.
Yeah, I stayed out for 9 hours. Sure.
Yeah. And
it's like everybody was looking for you.
But you called.
You have to get out sometime.
Yeah, but you called Bobby and said I'm lost. But Bobby lives in New York.
Yeah, I know. Well, I talked to him a couple of times.
Save it too.
Where's Bobby? I want to talk to him.
What's that got to do with Bobby? That ain't got nothing to do with
him. I want to understand.
myself.
I just hit once
Bobby,
in a while.
How you doing, man? Good to see you. What is
I just hit once in a while. I don't know much.
Bobby, are you still representing Beetlejuice?
Yes.
You are.
Yes.
Are you in charge of Jolly Dwarf? You are. You're still in charge of that business.
Yes.
And Beetle is your primary client.
Right.
When Beetle announced he was moving down to Georgia, did that send the whole organization into a panic?
Yeah, to a tailspin.
No, seriously. I mean, you like at first, like, hey, you can't go to Georgia. I need you here.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Very inconvenient happening in Georgia.
So how was that?
How does it work?
Well, we booked up here and we got just a lot of, you can't travel alone, so I have to send Puppet.
Oh, Puppet. So you sent Puppet with him to Comic-Con?
Yes.
Because I thought that he was cheating on you with Puppet, like you had a new manager.
No.
Puppet's your guy.
Yeah, so when we booked Comic-Con,
yeah,
we had to book a flight for Puppet from... By the way, his sister that you met didn't die, Howard.
Oh, she didn't?
No, his other sister died.
Oh, his other sister. Oh, you see, the sister I met is alive.
No, she's in New York, I think.
No, she's in Georgia.
Right out of Georia with me. Yeah.
So
no,
you're living
she
with...
wasn't in New York. I said she's in New York.
Pete,
you're
living with your mom and your sister.
Yeah, that's what I said. She's in New York.
When he got lost, his sister and the
mom... That ain't got nothing to do with me. I said she's in New York.
When he
had
mic off for a minute?
Yeah, well, no, because he can go.
He's excited about the Academy Awards.
Yeah.
What, by the way, the new movie that's out, that's on DVD.
Yeah.
It's not a pornography.
No, no.
It's a horror film.
Oh. It's available on Amazon.com.
Let me play a clip from it, and then we'll get back into it.
This is Beetle's acting?
This is Beetle's acting. It's Beetlejuice and Sal. I thought I'd pull a clip from there. Can you set this up, Beat, for us at all?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, go ahead. Set up the clip. In this clip, I guess Beef and Sal plays Girls Gone Wild.
Right.
And I guess you were.
I'm just the guy that's doing it, you know?
You're just
I'm just the guy that's scaring people, you know?
So
you're a con artist.
Bobby,
yeah.
Bobby, what
that's
is Beef's
I'm a con artist.
I changed
everything around. He plays
just a guy on vacation that wants to get
Okay. So he's on vacation, he meets Sal, and this is the scene. All right.
Isn't Beetle on a permanent vacation?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah, definitely is, baby.
All right, Beetle, here we go. This is your scene. Let's listen to you act. Sal Dubernale, he's in Girls Gone Wild, and Beetle. Here we go, from the new movie.
Oh, hey,
let's go.
In this one. Keep moving, please. No comments. Yeah. Give yourself a pouch pin with that one. There you go. Hide your crack pipe in it, sweetheart. Way to go.
Oh, what a stuff.
Put that over your face. Make everyone happy.
Dynamite! There you go.
Carrot time! Well, what do you think, Robin? Not bad, huh?
I can't tell what's going on in this scene.
Well, it's a little confusing. Big, nice job. Nice job. Really good. You're good.
Howard, do you want to point out that working with Sal was very frustrating because he's very unprofessional?
Why is he unprofessional? Why?
He shows up too damn late.
He comes late to the set?
Yeah. Oh, I am lucky.
What about when we went to get him in his hotel room? What was hanging out of his ass?
Hey, he called me. When I came out the hotel, he had the fucking, I don't know, but he had a fucking thing up his ass.
What was it?
He had a condom up his ass.
He had a condom up his ass.
2 in the morning, he had a condom up his ass. 2 in the morning.
What is that about?
I got a condom up to my ass.
Hey, Pete, don't you miss living in New York and living with Bobby and the whole thing? I mean, this is crazy, being out in Georgia. There's no action out there.
Hey, what are you doing? You got to work, you got to work.
Yeah, I mean, what does he do all that? Seriously, were you upset that he was living in Georgia?
Yeah, very.
Oh, yeah.
He had a cell phone. He doesn't know he's calling. He just gets sent and whoever.
No. I'm back for money, but I know it, though.
So he calls me, like, 10 times a day.
Right.
I don't call like that.
and you're in New York.
He's in Georgia. I'm in New Jersey. And
right.
He says, yeah, I'm a fucking asshole. And I said, what's the matter? He goes, I'm a dumb motherfucker. I said, what's the matter? He goes, I went the wrong fucking way. I said, what do you mean? He went to get a slice of pizza and he got lost.
For 9 hours.
Yeah. That was at like 3 o'clock. They found him at like 1 in the morning.
Wow. And did you get upset? Did you start crying and stuff? Or is he okay?
Oh,
I mean, you know, do you get upset when you're lost? No?
Oh.
Wow.
Would you serve people a drink if you walked into a bar?
I would run for the hills. I would think I was in a nightmare.
Yeah.
Is anyone working? Is anyone working on getting Beatles some new teeth?
Loved him.
You lost it. Yeah.
Good enough.
Let me see what's going. Give me a smile. Wow. You lost a few more.
You have like a tunnel now.
Is it hard to eat? No. You couldn't. What?
Yeah.
No. What do you like to eat with that pizza?
I can eat pizza. I can eat anything.
Well, you chew on the side, I guess, huh?
Yeah,
but I'm saying you got no front teeth at all.
Can you eat steak?
Me? Yeah, I can eat steak, yeah.
Sure. All right, good.
Sure, that's good.
Yeah, good. All right. I mean, does the tooth fairy still visit you?
Yeah.
Wow, I can imagine. But, so Bobby, the management of Beetlejuice now, he's still with Jolly Dwarf. Even though he's in Georgia, you still manage him. Puppet travels with him. And that's the whole organization right now.
That's how it goes.
I see. And the mom, she takes Beetle. I guess she's got custody, huh?
Yeah.
So did you argue with her? Did you say?
No, not at all.
You didn't say to her, hey, Mrs. Whatever her name is, I need this guy here. I got to put him to work.
No, she cooperates.
She gets it. Never a problem, right? Well, there you go. It's
wow, I can't believe Vito left the area.
Do you like Georgia, or you like it better in New York?
Oh, no. It's all right. It's a problem.
Yeah.
He said call me. It's a problem. I said come.
What's that, Bobby?
As far as he knows, he's still in Jersey City.
He thinks he's still there, yeah.
Yeah, I'm not in Jersey, but I feel right.
Yeah,
yeah.
What's
do you have friends down in this new place?
Oh, yeah. I got a couple of friends down there.
Yeah.
Bobby, he's probably lonely now.
I'm not lonely.
Well, you don't have Bobby anymore.
I got friends.
Yeah?
A lot of people.
Really?
Yeah.
All right. I'm just worried about you.
Ain't nothing to worry about. I do it all the time.
Mm-hmm. Bobby, is that true? Is he a friend?
He does.
He does.
He's got a lot of family.
All right.
A lot of family?
Yeah. Right.
But I think he misses everybody.
I just miss everybody. That's all.
Yeah. All right. Well, listen, the career is going like crazy now.
Oh,
What's the plan on the movie? Are you doing any other promotion besides here?
Well, he had the release party last night.
Right.
In the Village.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And that went well.
Yeah. It's available on Amazon.com.
Bobby, you seem like a beaten man. This isn't what you thought life was going to be, right? Right? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You probably had dreams.
I'm a little crushed.
Why?
You know, my little buddy not being around anymore. Not only now, and smelling and seeing him.
Yeah. Well, listen, your living depends on him. I mean, you got to keep him going.
Yeah. Oh, he said that he's going. I can't do it.
And B, you know, I'm worried about what now you're 44 years old.
Wow.
Yeah. You know, I don't know what I do.
I'm worried about that. I'm a 44-year-old guy.
A little bit, eh? You're
a little belly.
You're
a little
belly.
You know, you're a little bit out of shape. Yeah, but you know, you wear a golf shirt, you need to show your age a little bit.
You know, down in Georgia living with his mom, he's not doing his Georgie style.
Right.
Oh, you know, oh, yeah, I can do it, Georgie style. There's no problem.
You can't get pussy in front of your mother.
Oh, yeah?
A what?
I can do that real quick while I'm looking.
Really? You getting laid down in Georgia?
Oh, a couple of times.
You believe in Bobby?
Yeah.
He did?
Really?
He gets a lot of pussy, right?
Yeah,
he does.
Wow.
Yeah. It's amazing.
Cost me a lot of money.
Bobby, be honest with me. When a hooker walks, like, I mean, you're good to beat, and you know, you'll set him up.
Yeah, you have to set me up. I can do that on my own now.
When a hooker walks in and you see beat, do they freak and will a lot of them run away?
I usually don't meet her until after he's done his thing and
right.
I paid him.
Right.
And that's when I meet him. She's flipping out to get paid.
Right.
Then I
flip
out. You know that. I fucking take the money.
No,
it's okay, honey. No, you
don't. Do any of them leave when they say, like, oh, I forgot I have an appointment?
Never mind. I got another appointment. And then I take out and say, good luck.
Does that ever happen, Bobby?
Yeah, it happens.
It happens.
mad. That's why I do it.
B should go hit on Lisa G. She's reading Fifty Shades of Grey. She said she's ready.
Ready.
Oh, so you walk in and you have the money, right? Yeah.
Well, the bachelor party. So usually, get this to it with a girl, and then I'm like, ah, it's all right, don't worry about it. He says, no, you know, you owe me money. Oh, don't worry, it's okay, honey, it's okay.
Yeah. Then I take him straight, and then I'm going on the block.
Yeah. Oh, so he doesn't catch on, right?
I'm going on
the line,
and then you go back and go to the line.
Hey guys, no, 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 son el chiltepino. Estamos a un lado, se llama PS4, antes se llamaba Pocket. Y hasta ahorita voy prendiendo el celular. Te invité, pero pues ya no me dijiste nada. ¿Tú eres de cristiana en tu casa?
Where's my kid? Check out the eyes. Check the eyes. Oh, Bills. How do I pay the Bills? Phone?
We love you though, but it is.
Galarga Venosa. Squasquin Bay.
Hello there, viewer. How are you? Send me a message. Playing some Sims. Not sure what happened. Sample analysis, okay, log on, results on the computer, log analysis, results, performance is alright, surgery, damn it, surgery, thermal is broken, I think, where is it, just a dumb thermal, no, it's not broken. Kid.
Yeah, I'm okay. Dipping a hundred. I was like chipping out.
No, 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 they're going home. Fishing left. Let's see. What is she doing? 2 days. Again? Okay. Let's go to bed. What the fuck are the bedrooms?
Friday night, uh-huh. We were talking about the what Phoebe's going to sing at my wedding, and I was like, wow, Phoebe's going to get up and sing something, and Natalie Maines is going to sing something, Dixie Chicks.
Right. And then you're not
going to
do anything, you're going to dance.
Yeah, but and now I got to do something.
But you seem really into it.
I'm into it.
But you're into it, like, it doesn't seem...
I'm just like, nervous that, like, people... Like, all of a sudden I feel this responsibility.
You do.
I
can
ask you
one thing?
Yeah. And Pat Monahan is supposed to come from training, and he's going to sing something.
Okay.
And then, like, Pat's wife's going to have a baby. And I'm like, oh, I fucking hope she doesn't have the baby, because Pat's coming.
Now she can't have a baby because it would ruin your wedding?
I hate that she's pregnant. I was looking forward to seeing that blood.
Yeah, she can't even
I don't think you're seeing her. Yeah.
But
he was in such a rush to knock her up.
One thing about the toast, Al, can I just say, is it something where I shouldn't be at all blue, you think? Like,
have fun. Make people laugh.
So I'm saying, like, a curse here and there.
Yeah, that's cool.
Okay.
Yeah.
I just
want to...
No, I know.
Yeah, no cursing. No cursing at Howard Stern's wedding.
No. But I mean, you know, Howard's a classy guy, and it's a classy, you know, I
believe me, I'm not that classy.
Don't do heroin in
right.
the middle.
Can you be straight for it?
Does Robin have
Meanwhile,
to go there?
I had my bachelor party. You didn't even ask me about my bachelor party.
Well, I was going to bring that up because I thought.